Howdy, Chucks. Oh, sorry, Mick wanted me to say bonjour. Hello. Aya. Shut up. Right, these are Charisma, and I think there might be a Parisma couple in there as well, coloured pencils. And they're all in warm grey, different depths of colour in warm grey percentages, and I'm going round and putting the shadows in to make it a bit more 3D. Now in the next bit you're probably gonna, I don't know, be horrified at what I'm doing with it, but so far it bear with it, it don't look so bad, does it? Does it? He's shaking his head. So, yeah, I'm just putting shadows in. I don't really know what I can tell you about it. But what I wanted to ask was, one of my lovely subscribers emailed me. She had my email address through something else, but she emailed me some art that she'd done, and pardon, that I'd inspired her to do, and I can't, I was so touched. I don't know what's up with me, I blub at drop of an hat nowadays, don't I? Anyway, it really touched me a lot, and what I want to ask you lot, well, there's two things really as well, but anyway, if any of you have done, it don't have to look like mine, just inspired or used a technique that I reminded you of or showed you or whatever. It doesn't matter if you're uploaders or not uploaders. I'd like people who don't upload especially to maybe email me your pictures. And I want to do a gallery, a video gallery of your works, you know, my subscribers' works. I'd love to do that. So my email address is it all in one, artifartifera@gmail.com, please. Right, this bit that I'm doing is tissue paper, and I'm ripping it up random sort of sizes. Some of it I'm scrunching, some of it I'm not scrunching. I'm piling it up in about the same quantity of paper, and I'm colouring it with autumn coloured brushes. Darker in places, not darker in places, some raw crystals on, so you know it does the burst things in places. And I've picked out, I don't know how many colours, about six, I think. And I'm now laying it down, scrunched up, straight, layering on top of each other, and bearing in mind this is not watercolour paper. It took it well to say that it's not watercolour paper. I'm sort of pushing it into nooks and crannies. Now I wish that I'd done a bit more thought. I sort of did do a bit of think, and I put the orangey, shut up you, I put the orangey in places and then the green in places to make it look like a blurred bush, if you will. Don't worry, I know it looks a mess at the moment, but excuse me a minute. Now that is a really nice effect, but not for what I was going for this. And luckily it came off in roughly two pieces, so I put it back on. And the spare bits that I didn't use, I put a bit more on, and where I wanted it a bit darker, or if it had crikey, that your tummy! Wow, I hope you didn't hear that. His tummy just gurgled really loud with starving. So I put them back on, and where there weren't much ink left in the tissue, I put the other bits back on. Now this is it with all the tissue removed. Ain't it pretty? I really like that background. But don't throw away the if you do it, don't throw away the tissue. There should be a video coming up pretty soon when I get a chance to do it. I've done it in my head, but I haven't actually physically made it yet. Then obviously my caster. Right here, I'm cutting out by the wet method, damp paintbrush, and I've put them little spots so I know that they go spot side towards each other, so it looks like a leaf arching away from you. Well, three leaves. I've just used those colour swasher things that I made to select a green that would stand out from the area that I'm doing it in. Now I'm obviously, I mean, you can see for yourself, I'm painting the little paper leaves with that green, drying it. That's just waste paint that I'm getting rid of. Drying it, then putting them back on the picture where I want them, and then wetting them. Don't worry, it looks a mess, but then it doesn't, because it's not watercolour paper, so it looks like it bleeds out all over the show, but it's not quite as bad as it looks. Then I reused them leaves, didn't apply any more paint on them just for now, but I do in a minute. But this is what I wish that I'd done more of in the background. When I initially did the background, I should have done sort of loose sketchy roses. I know it's sort of, oh, your tummy's at it again, stop it. Loose sketchy roses and more leafy sort of shapes. So it's like a blurred photograph. That was just water, wasn't it? I do add a little bit more paint to it. And then my brain gets to thinking, you know, what it's like. I think, oh, a bit of shadow on there. So that's what I'm doing now, putting a bit of shadow on. Then I get to thinking, I wonder if I could put, oh no, that's still shadow. If I could put veins on leaves, so just, you know, subtle tiny indication of veins. I didn't use it strong enough, and I wouldn't dare go any further because this paper really is, it's basically saying, back off, one more step and I'm going to disintegrate on you. I'm asking a lot for it, from it. Right, that's what it was like at the end of the last video, and this in a second is what it looks like at the end of this video, obviously. And then it's took a screen grab of what I'm at now. If you look to the right, there's some proper leaves under the bud. Yeah, I don't think they can see cursor pointing at it, love. And I'm doing some more colour on the petals, and I've got some of the white highlights up as well. Bye bye. Sorry, thanks for watching. Bye.